officiating out the middle this afternoon, we have Zach Schwoss. And not long until we get underway for kickoff. Local Rugby League action is sponsored by Gen Z Employment this season. Very good supporters of Rugby League on the Gold Coast. Kickoff here this afternoon, nice and deep into the corner from Runaway Bay. Currumbin Eagles running right to left on your screen. Strong carry back into the line. 15 metres out, plenty of Runaway Bay Seagulls there to meet him. Interesting form so far to start the year for both teams. They've both been up and down and searching for consistency this afternoon. I think both teams are one win, two losses to begin the year as we head into round four. And a win would certainly help the chances of both pushing up into the top part of the ladder. Strong carry there for Currumbin. This has been a good set so far, pushing them up over the halfway line. Nice high kick. This will challenge the fullback for Runaway Bay. Handles it easily. Strong carry back into the line, but upended there from the Currumbin defence. Great tackle.
As Runaway Bay work it out from their own end here, we'll have a quick moment and announce the teams for today. We'll start with the away side, the Runaway Bay Seagulls. In the fullback position, we have Steve Tolo. On the wings, we have Jared Marina and Ian Favave. The centres are Tyron Studer and Matt Gundy in the 16 and the 4, respectively. The 5-8 is Filoni Arkell. The 7 is Connor Tola. The two big props are Gene Rapama and Dyron Harper-Porter. Number 9 is Ethan Gallup. In the back row, the number 11, Ben Piua and Taturi Hapaku. And the 13 is Henry Chang. On the bench today, we in the 19, Vili Tuli. 15 is Panuma Pahipi. And the 14 is Corey Tupsell. For the Crumbin A grade side, they are coached by James Griffith. In the fullback, we have Kyle Ramage. The 2 is Savran Rapana. In the 3 is Ken Allison. And the 4 is Logan Guire. The 5 is Scott Tafua. Our halves, the Crumbin Eagles halves today are Kendall Moylan in the 6 and Braden Evans in the 7. James Griffith, the coach, is pulling on the jersey this afternoon. Just coming a bit of a craze nowadays in the league. Coach is wanting to get out there again. The hooker is Dane Barr, and the other prop today is Kingi Akula. The 11 is Darren Holton. The 13 is Jake Barnett. And on the bench for Crumbin this afternoon, number 14, Bailey Court. 15, Richie Haloney. 16, Tonga Likliki. The 20 is Sone Akula. And the 19 is Jared Gill. As Runaway Bay clean up this ball here and begin to work it out through their own end. The tackle there was made by Kendra Moylan. Bit of a positional change there for Canada today. He's been playing a lot of fullback for the Crumbin side. But obviously Crumbin have had a few changes this week with the return of a couple of players from a bit of a breakaway from rugby league.
Strong start here to both teams. There hasn't been a mistake so far. This is the first penalty of the game going to Runaway Bay. Be interesting to see if they can capitalise from it. It's become something of the norm in the league almost that the teams giving away a penalty are struggling to hold the defence, and penalties often leading to tries now.
I just have time off while we wait for the second ball to come off the field. Looks like the Bull Boys might have had a quick little nap in between that game there as Runaway Bay approach their 50 metre line. The 13 is taking the hit up there, Henry Chang.
Henry Chanting is been a late call-in for the Gold Coast rep team this year. That rep team will see in action next weekend at the Chairman's Challenge out in Ipswich.
As Runaway Bay
searching for higher rules.
Runaway Bay making a back one play. A bit of speed there. Just checking that in. Fire shooter. A bit of speed out wide there for Runaway Bay. Expect to see if that means split. Big hit there for the Kingi Akula.
Good shot. Chris Clark, he'll be wanting to run in the ball a bit harder next time.
Stevie Tolo's tackled there.
Can't have a
last hangover, handover.
not a bad play. A bay defence that is set.
As the experienced Savrapana takes a little hit up there.
Good numbers into the tackle. Down, back to the end.
That's the number 5, even for Vave. And two people.
He's a big boy. He's going to be hard to handle on the edge today if they get some good ball to him.
As Kyle Ramage takes his kick, bit of a cold torpedo bomb there. Runaway bait on the field and bounce, and Steve Tolo brings it out. Ford's Runaway Bay aren't in a rush to get back because there's a little mistake, but it's gone back to the goal. Hapuku's tackled there.
Sloppy there from Runaway Bay. Chris.
That's V number 8. Four Runaway Bay gets tackled there. Ripoma. As they have a little backline play to the left here. Cut out pass to centre for Runaway Bay. And Matt Gundy's tackled there. Just past his 40 metre line. Fifth and last here. Two pass finds the halfback. Well done, Sav. Coming fans are quick to let the referee know. I think they missed something there. As Crumbin work it out. James Griffiths, the coach, takes a hit up there, goes to short side. Oh, he's called obstruction, I believe. Especially after they don't get a penalty for that height, for that lifting tackle there, and then the old phantom call.
Side.
Well, as we've seen in the NRL, the obstruction rules have been a bit of a talking point so far this season, especially with the introduction of the bunker. Unfortunately, at local league, we don't have the ability to send it upstairs to the bunker yet. Hey, but who knows? Maybe in a few years' time, we might be able to get a video ref going at local grounds. As Runaway Bay go on the tacky, tackled 15 metres out. Hapaku's tackled there. Three players in the tackle there for a Crumbin. Got to control the ruck well here. In the wet, you don't want quick play of the ball. Looks like Runaway Bay out left. Shots about getting in Runaway Bay. Back down the face. Bit of a settler, you'd call it. Just past their 20 metre line. Can't make out who that number 4 it is for Crumbin. Logan Geyer.
Finds gets the offload away. Players pushing out. James Griffith into the line.
Oh. The coach is showing the young boys what to do there. He's just bowled over the 16 from Runaway Bay.
Good James yards Hunter. There on the first play. Shifts out to the wing. Bit of space here to the outside. Runner back inside.
Savrapana.
Beats one. Beats two.
Offload.
Jack
Gills chase up.
And it's going to be the team that can complete and hold onto the footy that's probably going to come away with the points. Disappointing. definitely an opportunity to the outside, but the wet weather.
Interesting so far, you think, with the wet weather. And then you throw the ball around nice and open. So,
Rapana.
As Matt Gundy takes a strong hit up there, it's tackled really by Kyle Ramage and Kenan Moylan. Right, I may get a quick play of the ball and go left again. I think that's not going to be called a knock on there. Crumbin's advantage.
That's certainly what we're going to see a lot of today.
Wet weather footy. Haven't had a bit of rain for a while, but in the 19s game this morning, apparently it was bucket hitting down. Boys got a bit wet out there in the under 19s. Reserve grade was pretty dry, but obviously still a lot of surface water here.
The Currumbin field is holding up well, though. In years gone by, this Currumbin patch used to just turn into a quagmire with a tiny bit of water, but looks quite nice out there today. It's not going to be too hot for the players.
What's the ref going to call here? Play on. Kyle Ramage is tackled there on the 10-metre line. Currumbin go right through Dane Barr, who goes underneath for Jake Barnett. Takes the short side on.
Connor Toya, he's an experienced young player. Connor, he came from through the Burley system. A little bit of Queensland Cup experience under his belt already.
Expect to see a bit more of that today. Knock on twice the line.
Yeah, I don't think. See, that's the hard one. When you got your coach out there, if he was on the sole, he'd be tearing his hair out of what little hair he's got. swearing at his players, saying, just hold the ball, take the tackle. And, when he's out there himself and tries to pop one when he probably should have just taken the tackle. Always difficult being a captain coach.
As a referee, just lets league safe know he's not meant to be on the field. During a scrum, it's going to be Runaway Bays. Loose head and feet.
There are some big, strong ball runners there for Runaway Bays. They go to the short side.
They find a little second place play there. Can't make out who that number is just yet. Pretty tackled by three players there from Crumbin.
Not sure if Clinton Toopey would be happy to see him throwing the ball around like that from their own end. Good to, again, just a couple of little clinical errors there for Runaway Bay where players just aren't quite pushing up as much as they should. If they can get those little things right, they're going to cause some dramas here for Currumbin. Strong carry again from Reece Clark. Almost Sam Thaiday-like where he just shoots in at the legs, gets up for a quick play of the ball.
Another quick play of the ball there for Runaway Bay as they go left. They found Matt Gundy out there, out wide. Tackled by the winger and centre for Crumbin, Tafur and Gaia.
Good set off their own line for Bay.
Picked the last here. Big kick here.
Well, that's going to be a test out. Good Torpy. It's coming down.
Sabrapart is under it. We'll take it well.
All class tries there at the back.
Tries to go around him. Got a quick play the ball here, baby. It's Kenny Allison takes a scoot there. Beats one.
Oh.
Ran into a brick wall.
Crouching
defense. Keeps going. Defense
borderline number three.
There's Runaway Bay working left. The 11 was lining him up there from Crumbin.
Good fit there for him.
Numbers to the right if they go right. No one's home. Bit of an interesting scenario there happening for Crumbin. It looks like Savrapana's going in between the left wing and the fullback position and letting Kyle Ramage play a bit more like a lock in defence. But as we saw then, it might not be that good of an idea. The winger for Runaway Bay was just left wide open there.
It's surprising because Kyle Ramage hasn't been too bad in the halves to start of the year, and Keita Moylan has been outstanding at the back. It surprises me that they've done a swap. I think it can't be too long given the... If Bay continually put points on, then I think we'll see those two swap around again.
As Runaway Bay going to get a conversion here? Looks like there might be a few subs coming on for Crumbin. Well, Crumbin are carrying an extra half on the bench today with young Bellicorp in the number 14. So that might be a potential play they're looking at with an extra halfback running around.
Yeah, he's a handy young player, Ballycourt. You'll actually see the family, the King's Court on King's Hill there and under the blue pop-up probably on your screens at the moment. Just to the right of the screen, the Court family. Follow the Suns everywhere, but he's a pretty handy player, young Bailey.
As Stevie Tolo lines his conversion up, difficult kick in the wet. Saw a couple times in reserve grade, the goal kicker slipped over as he's running in. Tolo will be hoping he doesn't have the same luck this afternoon. He lines this one up. And strikes it. It's just going to slide left, slides to the right, unfortunately, for him.
Conversion there was unsuccessful. Leads the score, 4 points to nil,
favour of the season. Needed the Jonathan Thurston curl to get that one through. He set it up right, just didn't quite curl for him, just hit it dead straight.
As Kenan Moylan's going to take the kick off here for Crumbin. Looks like they're going to go left off the kick off here. Big deep kick off, is he going to? No, it's hit the ground. Bouncing along. Taken there by the 16.
Nicely there for the winger.
Taken there by Tyrone Studer as he's tackled there by two. Crumbin players just past his 20-metre line. We've had Stevie Tolo. It's taken a hit up there for Runaway Bay. Fullback's been involved a lot lately in so far in this first half. As number eight, Jinra Pahame takes a strong hit up there. Tackled by two players. As Runaway Bay go to the short... Oh. Good hit there. Had to make that tackle when he's shooting that far.
Crumbin player shot out of line.
Believe that was tackle. Scott Tafua. That's run away.
Fifth and last. Connor's always been putting up some high kicks. Throws up
not as high.
This would be a lot easier for Kyle Ramage at the back.
Taken well by Kyle as he has a little bit of a slip and a slide. And tackle there on his 10-metre line.
Really good finish to a set after the kick, after a try, though.
That Savrapana takes a hit up there for Crumbin. Makes a couple extra metres with a bit of a leg drive there. Again, Moylan goes to the short side. Dummies one way, comes back the other. Finds his lock, Jake Barnett, who beats one. Ends up tackled in the 40-metre line. Jumps a couple metres forward there as Jared Gill goes left. Finds Braden Evans. Tries to dance his way around the defence and ends up getting just past the 50-metre line.
Closing number manages to wrap him up.
Fifth and last, big kick. Oh, they're going to run it. Richie Hiloni, I think that is. No, sorry, that's Kingy.
Kingy Akula. Not the right play probably in the end there for Currumbin. I think if Kingy had been hitting onto that ball at speed, it might have been a little bit different, but he's probably stop-start, waiting for the kick himself.
As
I think he'd be disappointed that he didn't get a front-rows kick away.
The 16 for Runaway Bay takes a hit up there. Tyrone Suter, tackled by Jake Barnett and Jared Gill there as they go left here.
Big Gene again.
They're going to go left again. It looks like they're going left a fair bit this afternoon. Well, good tackle. He's lost that.
Still as long as there, unfortunately. Yeah, I think that's what I said, that if they keep attacking to that edge of Currumbin, there's some big boys out there that they can tire out really easily. And come the back end of this half and then into the second half, they're going to find some luck on that side, running at some tired players.
So Currumbin are going to get loose out and feed here, just short of the 40-metre line.
Given Bay have also got Matt Gundy on that side, really handy player. I think he'll find some joy later today. Currumbin's chance to go on the attack though.
As Kyle Ramage finds the number 4 for Currumbin, who spreads it out to Kenny Allison.
Expensive footy from their own end.
You'd think they'd just be telling the forward to take a hit up so far, a bit of drop ball. Let's come and make a few subs.
That's it. They could be guilty of trying to go sideways a little bit too early here in the game rather than just pushing forward through the middle. There's the three. Made some really
Kenny
good
Allison.
Yards there, Ken Allison.
Good offload there from Logan Guy, who's up for number 4. As Crumman go right, Ken Moylan steps one. That's going to be 6 to go.
Six more.
As Scotty Tafua ends up with a ball there out wide. Crumman definitely on the attack now as the referee signals 6 to go. Looks like the 16 for Crumman is on. Tonga Likiliki. And takes a hit up there. Tackle there.
Tonga Likiliki, he has a lot of experience, so we look to him to lead the way forward for this Currumbin pack.
Quick play of the ball again for Crumman. They've got Runaway Bay in the back foot here. As they go left, James Griffiths takes a line on.
Oh,
he's
going to
go over, I think. He's got it.
He's got there. It's an inspired run. He's throwing the big dummy out the back. And I don't know if the Bay guys have just... falling for it, was just really poor defence. But a great try there from James Griffith, did it all himself.
Sean Gay's, he's a proper, thinks he's a halfback again.
Reliving the glory days of his youth. It's no surprise, every front rower thinks they're a halfback.
Oh, absolutely. Looks like Braden Evans is going to take this shot at goal here. Don't want to jinx it late, but should kick it from here.
So it could be end-to-end stuff here from the both teams. They completed really well to begin with. We're expected with the wet weather to be a very sloppy affair this afternoon, but the completion rates for both sides are quite respectable.
As Braden Evans lines up this conversion. Fairly decent turnout considering how wet it was this morning. Expected a few people to stay at home, but looks like we've got a fair few people to come watch this great A-grade game this afternoon. As Braden Evans converts that goal and takes the point score at 6 points to 4 in favour of the Eagles.
Conversion there was successful. This leaves the score 6 points to 4 in favour of the Eagles.
It's a pretty handy strike there from Braden Evans. Currumbin take the lead for the first time today. As we always say, this would be the most important set so far. The one straight after a try.
So many times have we seen a team not complete the set after scoring a try.
Well, it cost the Broncos a grand final last year, didn't it?
Many
lack of concentration.
Hey, folks, in the doubles, you need the opposition to have number 2 and the home side number 8.
As Runaway Bay go deep into the left-hand corner here. Their left-hand corners. With that, Scotty Tafua works it out from his own end and ends up making it to the 20-metre line. Crumb and appeal for a penalty, but denied. Oh, number 17.
Oh,
forward pass. That's a big call.
Yeah, that's it's a tough one there, but as we said, it's the most important set. Currumbin haven't been able to complete it. It's going to put him under big pressure here.
As we just wait for confirmation, who is the number 17 for Currumbin? Beats here, you know, cooler, we believe. As Runaway Bay
going to
go on the attack here.
Tough call there, though, for the forward pass there. Albeit we're not in line, but looked all right here from the commentary box.
As Runaway Bay find their prop.
Big Gene.
Big Genie. Tackle there, I believe that's Jared Hill.
He's had some tough carries, but he hasn't really been hitting the ball as hard as he could. Good line there on the edge for the Bay runners.
Good tackle from the Currumbin 5-8, Kenna Moylan. tells him to take it back a couple of metres as we find a marker. As they go right here, Big Genie goes again.
Quick play the ball at the sticks, and they could have him caught short here again on the right edge.
Substead.
They go that way.
They go right.
Short ball to Steve Tolo.
Tackled there by Kyle Ramage.
Honk didn't quite open up for him. Fifth last. Connor Toyer heads to the back. He's going to kick long to his winger out of the left edge. He's probably kicked to.
Looking for Favave. Yeah,
too big there.
Goes into touch. The handover to Crumbin, I believe.
The winger on the right hand side here.
They might get some joy out of that.
I think Crumbin have been pretty smart though. They put their tallest winger out there as well. I think Sam Rapana's on right wing here. As Dunbar finds Licky.
Oh, strong carry.
So that wasn't Licky. That was a Sione Akula. As they go right here.
To four? No, Licky.
Strong hit up there, just makes a pass. He's 40 metres.
It's amazing, isn't it? You look at the front rowers, they got the same build as the wingers these days. Hard to tell them apart from the commentary box.
That was a weird ball from Brad Nevin.
Ken Allison gives himself out. That's a voluntary tackle.
He thought he might have been called for
a... If the Bay bloke was a bit smarter and doesn't jump on him, there's a chance for a penalty there. Jared Gill hits one up.
Strong hit up from Jared Gill.
Almost gets an arm free to get a ball away.
Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen, we've just found a hearing aid on the ground. If anybody's lost a hearing aid, come and see us. 13,
well and truly offside.
Yes, you heard it right, a hearing aid. But worth a lot of money, so if you want to come and see us.
Good attempt to tackle there for Dane Barr. Strong hit.
He goes all day, Dane Barr.
Bounced off a little bit, but was back in there.
That's Crumbin. Make a tackle there on the number 5. Ian Favave for Runaway Bay. Another hit up. Sione Akula makes that tackle. As Runaway Bay go right.
Runaway Bay really again. Haven't made any yards there.
Knock on. Coach killer.
From the pressure of Karama's defence, so they worked hard for each other there. They forced a mistake.
So Karama gets to go on the attack here again.
It's amazing what a little bit of intensity lifts in the defensive line can do for your team. They all worked pretty hard for each other there with some strong chases out of marker and strong push-up from the A's and B's.
A couple of good tackles there from Sione Akula as Crumbin Eagles go right from the scrum. Find Kyle Ramage finds his winger, Scotty Tufua.
Forcing him to the sideline.
Referee calls penalty.
Oh, he's pinged him for a shoulder charge. I think that's a tough call.
So Crumbin not going to worry about a kick. Oh. Now they're going to go for touch here. Kendall Morland finds touch. Just past his 20 metre line. Great attacking position here for Crumbin. Another try would be helpful. Heading into the later part of this first half of the game. As Dane Barr takes the tap. And finds his experienced Licky Licky. Strong hit up again from Licky Licky.
Takes four of the Bay defenders to get him to the ground. The strength of the man.
Come and go right. Number 4. Logan Geyer finds an offload and finds his coach, James Griffiths. He's looking for his second McFly.
I think he might have dropped that one. Yeah, he might get away with it here. No, he doesn't.
Touchy found it.
Almost got away with that one.
I think it was a touchy call that made that one.
Disappointed there. He was probably in the same position to where he scored his try, where he could have thrown the big dummy out the back.
He got a bit excited again. Yes. Not too often you can have two meat pies in a day for a prop.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's probably under 9 the last time he scored a double.
Everyone loves scoring a double, especially the old props.
Well, they love the double cheeseburgers.
As Runaway Bay have the loose head and feet here, Connor Tolo will feed the ball through the scrum. It goes right. I believe that is Matt Gundy. Taken there by Kyle Ramage and Kendall Moylan. Another strong hit up there for Runaway Bay for the 13.
Henry Chanting.
Runaway Bay go right. And
Big Gene again. He's got some minutes in him. He's doing really well out there this afternoon.
Been out there for almost 30 minutes now, taking plenty of hit-ups. Another strong hit up.
Gets through. Quick 19. Play the ball coming here. Karamib, just get up and play it, son. You had him on the ropes.
Is that Genie again?
Yeah, two hit-ups in the set. Whoa. Almost gets an offload away.
next to the 50 metre line. Great set there from the way back.
Good set coming off their line and a strong finish.
Kyle Ravage takes his bob well. Manages to beat one.
He looks to be a slippery character, Kyle Ravage there at the back.
Very good young player there, Crumbin picked up. As the 16 Licky Licky takes another hit up there.
He's really shown his big display of strength. Four in the tackle, they couldn't put him to ground.
Oh, that's a strong hit. There from Runaway Bay. Brick wall defense.
The 13, Henry Chanting.
As they go on the attack, they go to the corner. Matty Cunningham come from nothing.
That's unbelievable for Runaway Bay. Fantastic shot from Andrew Chanting. And the Runaway Bay backline would just scoop up the ball really quickly, put it through their hands and found space. Great try.
Of the Seagulls number four, Matt Gundy.
Well, something out of nothing there for the Runaway Bay Seagulls. They all got caught up in the hit, just seeing, marvelling at how good it was. And before we know it, they're in the corner for a try, Bay. Back in front, 8-6.
9 minutes to go in this half. Been a strong game so far. Been really enjoyable. As it starts a little bit of pitter-patter rain coming along.
Yeah, looking out to the west, doesn't look any different to looking out to the east. I've got no idea where the rain's coming from.
I might have to get on the phone and ring the weatherman. As a difficult kick here for Runaway Bay. Can't make out who the kicker is yet. Believe it's still Stevie Tolo as his headgear's next to the tee there. Very difficult kick so far. Will be a very difficult kick. Lines it up.
Not a lot of talk there between the
Currumbin players. Pushing forward for the final 8 minutes of the game.
Half.
Oh, sorry, they're getting the half there. We've still got a second half to play.
Getting a bit ahead of ourselves. Decent strike. He's nailed it. Great kick.
Strong kick there from the sideline.
Stevie Toller. Takes score out 10.6 in favour of the Seagulls.
Conversion there was successful. This leaves the score 10.6 in favour of the Seagulls.
Body language just doesn't quite appear to be right for the Currumbin Eagles.
You know, they forced an error not long ago through some really intense defence, and looking at the body language, it just doesn't appear to be there.
Good kick from Kendall Moylan. As the Runaway Bay player makes his
strong
way back.
Strong carry into the line.
I believe that was the number 10 for Runaway Bay. As they go left here, they find number 2. Jared Marina takes the hit up. They go left again for the 19.
Number 10 on the field, Dorian Hapearu. He's a giant of a human and only young. He's been selected in the under-20s representative team. And looking at the size of him, he's probably the biggest player out there.
Kind of might be a bit of trouble here.
Oh, he's got his eyes, Dorian.
Commentator's curse. Give the kid a rap.
Look at how big he is, though. He's only 19 or
20 years old, and Jesus. He's a mere mountain.
So you're going to have a quick break here in time. Looks like Jake Barnett's receiving a bit of treatment there. Looks like there's not going to be much of a play here from Crumbin. Haven't seen a lot of plays from Crumbin off scrum so far this season.
In the two
games that we've been able to broadcast to you live.
Been very plain. Just one out running. In this sort of weather, though, you probably expect to see that again.
Looks like Jack Barnett's going to go off here. And they'll make a substitute. Can't make out who is going to come on.
Seven minutes remaining in the half. It really has been a seesawing affair. Back and forth. Nothing really flashy between the two teams. A bit of expansive play, but no real players. Chip here we go, chip through.
Number
who's got the legs
coming
to get there?
Logan
the
wheels, Geyer.
Number four. Logan Geyer, he's going to get there. Score in the corner, he is. Ooh. Great try there for the Currumbin Eagles.
Just as we say, we haven't seen a lot of plays off scrums. Eh? A little chip and chase.
Backed himself for pace there.
Great caught, try there for number four, Logan Geyer.
Caught Runaway Bay napping.
It's a good kick there from the 5-8, Kendall Moylan.
Yeah, he had it on a piece of string, didn't he? Put it in the perfect spot. The bounce was perfect. Up it came. Logan Geyer shooting through, trying the corner. We're locked here at 10 apiece. That's what we said. There hasn't been a lot of razzle-dazzle, and they pull that out.
Looks like that's going to lock up the scores for half-time. Unless Braden Evans can convert this try.
Cheeky play. That Clinton Tupi will be filthy, the coach of Runaway Bay. Those are the sort of tries where you just shake your head and think, how? How does that happen?
Fall asleep for a second and yeah. As Brad Evans lines his conversion up.
His first strike was really nice. It's not on his preferred side, but if he strikes it clean and straight like he did in the first kick, we should see the flags raised.
Lines it up. Couple steps back, comes forward. It's looking good off the boot.
Yeah, waved
just
away.
Pushes left, I think. They'll keep scores locked up at 10 points all.
Successful. This leaves the scores 10 points all.
We go back into an arm wrestle now, 10 apiece.
5 minutes to go in this half.
Currumbin failed to complete their set after their first try. The pressure's going to be back on them again here. It's a must-complete set. Find their fronts, get to the kick. Get it back down, Runaway Bay's end, and put them under pressure.
Looks like the 7 for Runaway Bay is going to take this kickoff. Connor Toller. Finds Crumbin Eagles.
Did get a lot of distance on that kick. Strong carry back into the fence. Barnstorming run.
Number 11 there. Darren Holt. Sorry, not Darren. Must have been Darren Holt in there for Crumbin.
Slow play, a little injury here.
Bit of an injury for Crumbin.
Man down, I didn't catch his number.
Not sure just who it is. Just calls for the trainer.
Injury timeout. Player getting assessed. It's really anyone's game, this one. 4 minutes to go in the first half, and at this point, I can't pick a winner. Both sides have had some flashes of brilliance. As has been the start of their season, though, they're both searching for consistency. Well, the referee's called a player out here. He's having a chat to him.
Number 20 for Crumbin.
I think there may have been a little bit of banter going on between some of the players, and the referee, he's pulled up Sione Akula because of it. Must have taken offence to something he said.
As the sports trainer gives the player the all clear to go back on. Still not sure who it was that went down with the injury there. But either way, we'll be about to start the game again.
Is that the? I think it might have been the winger, Scott Tufua.
Oh, Sione Akula smashed there, but
gets an offload away. Dane Bart.
They go left here, coming on the attack now. Jack Gill finds his winger.
Rapana step back to the inside. Goes back outside again. Good yards there for Currumbin. Their second phase play has really been handful for the Runaway Bay defence this afternoon.
As Dane Bart takes a little scoot and finds his 19, big Jared Gill.
Gill comes back in behind the ruck. Good yards.
Fifth and last here, big kick for Crumbin. Look for a repeat set or a big spiral.
Braden Evans, he's going to come back to short side.
Needs to get rid of it here.
He's been caught.
Finds Kenny Allison.
Kenny Allison puts one up. Speculator.
Where's he going to bounce?
No one's going to go for it. No one's going to go for it. Currumbin could pick it up here. No.
Matt Gundy. Kenna Moylan and Kyle Ramage. Oh, he kicks it.
Oh, he doesn't quite have the speedsters on his inside chasing that one down. I think he had a couple of back rowers. Quite probably not the right play.
Well, coming from this right-hand side, closest to us on screen.
The Bay defence at sixes and sevens here. If Currumbin can shift the ball around a little bit, they could find some space.
Logan Guy
almost gets through.
Currumbin could go on the attack here again just before halftime. It's Yoni Akula takes a hit up.
End to end.
And beats him. The big fella. Off left, right, and centre. He just keeps going, the big fella. As they go right, finds the 17. Just waiting on confirmation still who is this player. Just come and go right. Might be called forward from the ref. The player thought it was forward, but the referee didn't. As the 11. Big Darren Holton's tackled there. Fifth and last. Kenny Allison and Savrapana calling for the bomb. Kendall Mullen takes a scoot. Does just that. Look for Sav to go up here. Oh, he's taking it. It's going back.
I've got a feeling that Sione Akula could be the player in 17 and big Richard Olani. And he's pushed into number 20. Oh, strong hits.
From the Richie Olani.
That's a big front row.
We're
taking on a winger. The winger was no chance.
As Runaway Bay go left here. Oh, there's numbers here.
They found some space here. Little tip on again. Oh, the 11 will do it all himself.
Ben Platt.
Gets a pass away.
It's been approach half time here. Minute 30 to go here. Score's locked up. 10 points.
Connor Toyer, run it, son.
They run it.
Oh, puts a nice little kick through for his winger.
I think the referee must have called him off. Oh,
this is going to play on.
Oh, Kyle Ramage cleans up well at the back there.
Yes, I think Connor Toyer had been able to put it through the hands there instead of the kick. They might have found a little bit more joy, albeit it was scrappy play and Runaway Bay had an opportunity. Currumbin managed
to clean up. Oh!
Lost that.
It's a big hit there from the 12 from Bay.
They don't like... Oh! I think I saw a couple of swings there.
As things get a little bit spiteful now. Savrapana, I think he got hit by Totura Abuku in a really aggressive, strong hit. Forced the error, but he didn't quite like it. So Runaway Bay, the player's shooting over now to try and pack a scrum to stop the clock, and they'll have one final chance with about 30 seconds remaining.
As we get time off here.
Clock stops.
Everyone, we found our gentleman with the earpiece. He's just come and retrieve it. So thanks everyone for their effort.
Time on.
Ball comes out.
As they go left here, Runaway Bay.
Oh space in the outside. Show and go. Still going.
Oh, tackle well by Scotty Tafua. Finished off by Kendall Moylan there.
The six for Lani Arkelly. He was a handful then.
Threw it to himself a little bit there.
Matt Gundy, right footstep, twice, beats one, pass away, goes to ground, and he's in
Fine
touch.
Start, that'll be half time, we believe.
Yeah, we'll go into half now.
No one be rushing to pack this scrum. As the Hooter signs. So at half time, the scores are all locked up here. 10 points all. We'll have a quick break, and we'll be back shortly with more great football action.